I really feel I achieved my goals when students can do things for themselves. So when they actually become very self-regulated and automated learners. So rather than having me put in the guidelines for them, giving scaffolds and giving them help, I find that to be a huge achievement when students can monitor their own work. They know what they need to learn. They know how to get that information. They know how to critique the information, and they know whether their work is good and how to improve it. Hi, my name is Alice Leung. I work at Maryland's High School and I'm the head teacher of science. So my responsibilities is to supervise the science faculty and to build up the capacity of my team. I'm also in charge of also coordinating the technology in the school as well. We've got about 750 students and they come from a wide variety of backgrounds. So at the school, we haven't got a dominant cultural group. It comes from about approximately more than 50 different cultural groups. And what that means in my classroom is that I can actually really draw from the experiences of those students and their cultural backgrounds when we're looking at different perspectives on astronomy and how different cultures have used stars and the planets to navigate. We often draw on stories from like Aboriginal cultures, Maori cultures, and whatever stories that the actual students have themselves to bring. So I find that really enriches that experience and makes that global connections sort of really visible in my classroom. So what I think 21st century skills is about is there's different parts to it. So first of all is to be able to navigate through the very vast amount of information and to actually contribute to that knowledge base in the global world. So we do a lot of work in terms of having students be able to critique that information and actually allowing them to construct their own understanding and their own products to show that information as well. I think 21st century skills also involves being able to adapt to change. So at the moment, we've got a lot of rapid changes in technology, which results in a lot of rapid changes in our knowledge and understanding. And to be able to grasp that is something that I'm developing in my students as well. The learning environment that I think will foster 21st century learning is a flexible environment. So an environment where the kids are able to move the furniture, to set up a space that they think will best suit whatever activities that they might be learning at that time. So we're trying to work out, as young scientists, what information do we need to gather in order to actually work out whether we do need to kill some sharks, or if we do, what would actually happen to the environment? Do we need to save them, or do we need to actually have a shark cull? So what we're doing at the moment is we're having a shark conference. So like we talked about yesterday, the way that scientists work is we often specialise in particular areas. Okay, and then we come together in the conference and we share our expertise with other scientists. So some of the professional practices that I use for 21st century learning is project-based learning. So what that involves is having a unit of work where there is a real-life problem that is relevant to students. So as an example, my students are doing a problem at the moment called sharks, friends or foes, where they need to actually decide whether we should be protecting sharks or hunting sharks. That matters to them because they read on the news all the time, on TV news, in the newspapers, about shark attacks and how we should be culling sharks. So it's an issue that they've heard of and it matters to them. So what we've done is frame that as a problem, and then we put the kids into the role of real scientists where they have to research that information, look up the information and make a decision for themselves whether sharks or friends or foes. And what we've done is actually throw in an ethical element to that as well. So there's no right or wrong answer. As long as they back it up with the correct information, they'll be able to discuss that issue. You might have noticed that in the science classroom, each group of students, they're doing quite different activities. Initially, I planned in terms of what I want my students to be able to do and what skills they should have when they do project-based learning. And then I backward mapped it. And then I put in little, small, mini activities that built up those skills in terms of how to give each other feedback, how to talk to each other when doing a project, how to set short-term and long-term goals together as a team. All of those activities we've set up probably over some time, and that have all accumulated now to them being quite automated learners and be able to self-monitor themselves and their team. So in the holidays, I was reading a lot on Hattie's work in terms of how to bring his research into a classroom environment. And one of the things that he emphasised on was that teachers need to be constantly critically reviewing their own practice and to be reviewing how the students are learning as well. So one thing I've gotten from that is to regularly survey my students and to regularly gather data from a whole variety of sources. So in terms of student feedback, my students give feedback on their learning and my teaching to me every week. They tell me what they have learnt, they tell me what they have enjoyed learning, and they tell me what they have found difficult to understand. So from what they tell me, I then redesign the learning for them in the following week to address what they've told me. For the last few minutes, I'm just going to pick some people from age group, and they need to tell us what they've done today. Okay, and what their next step is going to be. Okay, so Veronica, can you tell us what your group did today and what you're going to plan to do next lesson? The way I develop the professional practices of teachers for 21st century learning is to make my teaching and learning very visible. So teachers are encouraged to come into my classroom to experience firsthand what a project-based learning classroom looks like and feels like. But I think also that school leaders have the responsibility to ensure that all the teachers in their schools are upskilled in that area and empower those teachers to come up with their own solutions for 21st century learning. What I find really important in the way I teach, the way I design learning for my students, or when I plan lessons or when I reflect on my blog, is learning and how students learn effectively and how students are able to learn the knowledge and the skills that they need to have in order to function in the world that they'll be living in when they're adults.